First of all, bone disease is the most common complication of multiple myeloma. In approximately 80% of patients at diagnosis, we see lytic lesions, and many of the patients have skeletal-related events, and we define these like pathological fractures, mainly in the vertebra. 25% of patients at diagnosis have a pathological fracture, and you understand that this creates a lot of pain for our patients, but also we have hypercalcemia of malignancy, we have spinal cord compression sometimes because of plasmacytomas or vertebral fractures, and we may of course need radiation or surgery to the bone. These are skeletal-related events that increase the morbidity and of course they impair the quality of life of our patients. So bone disease, I think, is one of the most important complications of multiple myeloma to be treated. The current management of multiple myeloma bone disease is based on the bisphosphonate use, mainly zoledronic acid and at a less extent of pamidronate. And this is mainly because of the MRC9 study comparing zoledronic acid and clotronate, which showed overall survival advantage in favor of zoledronic acid. So the majority, I think, of the physicians are using zoledronic acid, although in other countries like the Nordic countries, pamidronate is also used. The two drugs, zoledronic acid and pamidronate, have shown comparable efficacy in phase 3 study, but in the era of, let's say, conventional chemotherapy. The bisphosphonates are used in all patients who need active treatment, meaning in all patients with symptomatic myeloma. And the treatment duration is approximately 2 years for all patients. But then if the patients are in CR or very good partial response, then the treating physician can stop the administration of bisphosphonates. If the patients have achieved only PR or less than that, then the bisphosphonates have to be continued. And also at the relapse of the disease, the bisphosphonates have to be reinitiated. We say that and we recommend the stop of the bisphosphonates because of some side effects like the renal impairment and the osteonecrosis of the jaw. With the new drug denosumab, which is a monoclonal antibody against RUNX glycan, which is a potent, RUNX glycan is a potent activator of the osteoclast, so denosumab is inhibiting the osteoblast function. We believe that we may have a solution for renal impairment patients, because in the study that compares denosumab with zoledronic acid, we have seen much fewer renal problems with denosumab and adverse events compared to zoledronic acid. So I believe that for renal impairment patients, denosumab will give a solution, while zoledronic acid and pamidronate are not recommended for patients with creatinine clearance below 30.